大家好，我是 Stella，
我是博远。今天为你念的是练习手册
第82课，复习第63和64课。
第63课，世界之光，记着我的宽恕，把平安带给每个心灵。Lesson 63 The light of the world brings peace to every mind.Through my forgiveness,
世界之光，借着我的宽恕，把平安带给每个心灵。The light of the world.Brings peace to every mind through my forgiveness. Through my forgiveness.
我们今天要复习这些观念。We will review these ideas today. 世界之光，借着我的宽恕，把平安带给每个心灵。The light of the world brings peace to every mind through my forgiveness. 我的宽恕乃是世界之光，透过我而彰显于世的管道。 My forgiveness is the means by which the light of the world finds expression through me. 我的宽恕也是帮我意识到世界之光就在我心内的媒介。My forgiveness is the means by which I become aware of the light of the world in me. 我的宽恕乃是世界与我一同获得治疗的工具。My forgiveness is the means by which the world is healed together with myself. 为此，让我宽恕这世界吧，好让世界与我同愈。Let me then forgive the world that it may be healed along with me. 下面是活用这观念的几个具体建议。Suggestions for specific forms for applying this idea are 愿平安由我的心通传到你那里。Let peace extend from my mind.To yours. 我愿与你共享世界之光。I share the light of the world with you. 我必须透过宽恕才能看清此事的真相。Through my forgiven, I can see this as it is.
练习手册第64课。愿我勿忘自己的任务。Lesson 64 Let me not forget my function.
愿我勿忘自己的任务。Let me not forget my function.
愿我勿忘自己的任务。Let me not forget my function.我不会忘却自己的任务，因为我愿意忆起我的自信。I would not forget my function because I would remember myself. 我若忘了自己的任务，就没有完成的可能。I cannot fulfill my function if I forget it. 我若不能完成自己的任务，便无法体会到上主赐我的喜悦。And unless I fulfill my function, I will not experience the joy that God intends for me. 下面几个具体格式适用于今天的观念。Suitable specific forms of this idea include 不要让我为此而忘却自己的任务。Let me not use this to hide my function for me. 我愿利用这个机会来完成我的任务。I would use this as an opportunity to fulfill my function. 这事可能会威胁到我的小我，但它绝对改变不了我的任务。This may threaten my ego, but cannot change my function in any way. 以下是 J 熊的示意。You are blessed beings indeed. 你确实是有福之人。I am that one that you know as Jesus. And it is important in this time and place to really focus on your function. 我是你所知的 JC, 你在此时此地务必确实地专注于自己的任务。Your function is to awaken from the dream. What is the dream? The dream is living in your mind with illusory ideas, feeling all kinds of feelings because of those illusory ideas and thoughts, and not knowing that you are living in your own self-created dream.而你的任务就是从梦中觉醒。梦是什么？梦就是以虚幻的观念活在自己的心中，并因为那些虚幻的观念和想法而体验到所有的感觉，不知道自己正活在自己所打造的梦中。When you wake up through this process that we are sharing with you here,and that will continue on for some time for you. You are beginning to see that everything is a choice and that what you focus on becomes stronger and more powerful in your life and that your connection to the divine allows miraculous things to happen. 当你觉醒时，也就是你经由我们在此与你分享的这段过程，它会为你持续一段时间，你开始感到一切事物都是一种选择，而你所专注的事物会在你的人生中变得越来越加强。你与神的连结使不可思议的事得以发生。You begin to wake up to realize that you may lucid dream. You know what a lucid dream is.When you are laying in your bed and dreaming, it means that you know you're dreaming. 你开始觉醒而明白你可以做清明梦。你知道什么是清明梦，也就是当你躺在床上做梦时，你知道自己正在做梦。And that means that in the dream, you can choose to fly. You can choose to do whatever you want.And some of you have had that experience. 这意味着你在做梦中可以选择飞翔，你可以选择去做任何你想做的事。有些人有过这样的经验。Well, that is what a master is. A master is somebody who is lucid dreaming in this time-space reality. And that is a powerful experience indeed. 这就是大师的本质。大师就是某位在这个时空现实中做清明梦的人，这确实是非常非常美妙的经验。 To be fearless, to have the magnificent creative forces that have been given to you at your fingertips to do good and to share love and light and thatReally is the function that all of you have to share love and light. 也就是能够一无所惧地拥有伟大的创造力，你被赋予这份创造力，你可以随时用它来做美善之事，分享爱与光明。这确实是你们所有人的任务，分享爱与光明。It does not matter if you have completely accomplished this. If you are only sharing more love and light than you were a week ago, you are working miracles that you cannot even see, miracles that will show up in your life in fortuitous events and wonderful meetings and opportunities that would not have come to you otherwise. 你是否已经完全达到这个目标无关紧要。如果你只是比一周之前分享更多的爱与光明，表示你正在施展奇迹，这甚至是你无法想象的奇迹会出现在你的生活中，可能是意外的时间、美妙的会晤，以及你过去不可能拥有的机会。Of course, you cannot do a double-blind study to prove what your life would have been like. But we guarantee that when you pass over from this realm, you will be shown the many forks in the road that you have taken in your destiny using your free will.To choose love instead of fear, and you will see the network of miracles that sprouted from those loving decisions. 当然，你不可能做双盲研究来证明你的人生将会是什么模样，但是我们保证，在你离开这个世界之后，你会看到你命中注定要走的道路上有着许多三岔路口。而你用你的自由意志来选择爱而非恐惧，你会看到奇迹之网如从你爱的选择中萌芽。 And you will, if you are lucky, get to see what would have happened should you have taken the old road of fear and the ego's way. 幸运的话，你还会看到如果你选择旧有的恐惧及小我之路可能会发生的事情。 These are some of the great exciting things that you have to look forward to. Miracles spouting up all around you. Great health, great happiness, and wonderful, wonderful experience here. 上述便是你必会期待着令人非常兴奋的事情，奇迹在你周遭萌芽，完美的健康，巨大的喜悦，以及在此拥有的非常美妙的、美好的体验。It is not true reality. There is a reality beyond this one. But you begin to dream a happy dream. You are not living in pain and suffering and believing in every single illusion that you might make up.This is not a fun game when you are experiencing those kinds of things. 谁说这不是真正的实相？在这之上存在着另一个实相。但是你开始做幸福的美梦，你不会活在痛苦和苦难之中，并且相信着你的心灵所造出的每个幻象。当你经历痛苦的事情时，那可一点都不好玩。I am that one that you know as Jesus, and we encourage you to double down now on your practice. You have come into lesson 82. You have gone past the honeymoon period, where it's all very exciting and easy. 我是你所知的 JC, 我们鼓励你在自己的课程练习上更加把劲。你已经来到第82课，这表示你已经过了蜜月期。那时你非常兴奋且轻松的练习。You are now getting into the nitty-gritty of seeing what your mind can get up to. Do not be frightened of it. It is merely a cloud bank that is intimidating. 现在你正深入基本的事实，看出你的心灵之网罩本事，但请勿害怕它，它仅仅是一个吓人的厚云团，而你现在要求的是云团背后的光明。It is the light behind the clouds that you now want to seek. Whenever you see a shadow, whenever you see a dense cloud coming towards you,A fear or judgment, scarcity thinking, understand truly in your heart and mind that this is an illusion. It is not real. It is not God. 而现在要寻求的是云团背后的光明。每当你看到阴影时，每当你看到 浓密的云层向你逼近时，不论是恐惧、批判或是匮乏的想法，请确实地打从心里明白，那是一个幻象，它不是真实的，它不是出自上主。You are focusing on that which is divine, and you will be able to go through those mists, those confusing mists of illusion without harm. 现在你正专注于神圣本质，而你将能毫发无伤地穿越那些云雾，那些令人困惑的幻象云雾。And you will in fact experience that many, many times as you do these lessons. 事实上，在你做这些课程练习时，你会有许多次这样的体验。You will feel fear. You will call upon the lessons that you have learned.And you will go through that fear, and you will come out of the other side, and realize that it was nothing. 你会感到害怕，你会求助于你所学过的这些课程，且你会穿过那些恐惧，你会从另一头出来而明白，它是虚无的。It was an illusion that your mind had made up, but for many years,You would have believed those sort of things, and now you realize that you don't need to.
它是你的心灵所捏造的一个幻象。然而，多年以来，你一直相信这类幻象。现在，你了解到了，你无需如此。
I am that one that you know as Jesus. We will speak to you again tomorrow.
我是你所知的 JC， 我们明天再续。
让我们再来唱一次吧。
世界之光，借着我的宽恕，把平安带给每个心灵。Of the world brings peace to every mind through my forgiveness. Through my forgiveness, 愿我勿忘自己的任务。Let me not forget my function.
第八十二课，复习第六十三和六十四课。
第六十三课，世界之光，借着我的宽恕，把平安带给每个心灵。Lesson 63. The light of the world brings peace to every mind.Through my forgiveness. 练习手册第六十四课，愿我勿忘自己的任务。Lesson 64. Let me not forget my function. 奇迹正文第八章，回归之道。Chapter 8. The journey back.
第八节身体是手段或目的。8.The body as means or end.
第五节开始，身体并没有什么功能可言，这话一点也不假，因为它本身不是目的。
It is still true that the body has no function of itself because it is not an end.
然而，小我故意把它定为你存在的目的，如此才能延长身体的真正功能。
The ego, however, establishes it has an end because as such, its true function is obscured.
小我所做的每一件事都暗藏这个企图。
This is the purpose of everything the ego does.
它唯一的目标就是让你忘却万物原有的功能。
Its sole aim is to lose sight of the function of everything.
有病的身体这句话大有问题。
A sick body does not make any sense. 它之所以没道理，只因疾病不是身体原有的功能。It could not make sense because sickness is not what the body is for. 它之所以没道理，只因疾病不是身体原有的功能。It could not make sense because sickness is not what the body is for. 除非小我的身体观所根据的两个基本前提是颠扑不破的真理，疾病才可能成为天经地义的事。那两个前提即是身体是为了攻击而存在，以及你是一具身体。Sickness is meaningful only if the two basic premises on which the ego's interpretation of the body rests are true. That the body is for attack and that you are a body. 你若否认了这两个前提，疾病根本是不可思议的事。Without these premises, sickness is inconceivable. 疾病不过想要证明你是可能受伤的。Sickness is a way of demonstrating that you can be hurt. 它见证了你的脆弱，易受伤害，而且急需外来的指引。It is a witness to your frailty, your vulnerability, and your extreme need to depend on external guidance. 小我以此作为你期待他指引的有力说辞。 The ego uses this as its best argument for your need for its guidance. 他不容分说的为你开出一串处方，帮你预防所有的厄运。 It dictates endless prescriptions for avoiding catastrophic outcomes. 圣灵把这一切清清楚楚地看在眼前，却懒得分析其中原委。 The Holy Spirit, perfectly aware of the same situation, does not bother to analyze it at all. 因为收集的数据或资料本身毫无意义，岂能分析出什么结果？If data are meaningless, there is no point in analyzing them. 真理的任务只是收集真实的资料。The function of truth is to collect information that is true. 不论你用何种方法来处理错误的资料，又会得到什么结论。Anyway, you handle error results in nothing. 只不过结论显得越复杂，使人越难认清其实根本就没有这一回事。你无需一一查证那些前提所导致的结论，照样能对他们做出正确的评估。The more complicated the results become, the harder it may be to recognize their nothingness. But it is not necessary to examine all possible outcomes to which premises give rise in order to judge them truly. 学习工具不能充当老师。A learning device is not a teacher. 它无法教你如何感觉。It cannot tell you how you feel. 你连自己有什么感觉都说不清，因为你已被小我混淆了眼目，因而相信这个学习工具能够告诉你你究竟有什么感觉。You do not know how you feel because you have accepted the ego's confusion, and you therefore believe that a learning device can tell you how you feel. 疾病只是另一个例证，先是你死心塌地向一位不明就里的老师求教。Sickness is merely another example of your insistence on asking guidance of a teacher who does not know the answer. 小我不可能知道你的感觉的。The ego is incapable of knowing how you feel. 当我说小我一无所知，关于小我只有这一说法是千真万确的。When I said that the ego does not know anything, I said the one thing about the ego that is wholly true. 再沿用一下三段论证的推理，如果只有真知才有生命，而小我没有真知，那么小我便没有生命。But there is a corollary. If only knowledge has been and the ego has no knowledge, then the ego has no being. 你也许会问，一个不存在之物怎么可能发出这种锲而不舍的声音？ You might well ask how the voice of something that does not exist can be so insistent. 你不妨想想，当你渴望某物时，那种令你痴心妄想而又欲罢不能的魔力何其惊人，纵然那东西根本不存在。 Have you thought about the distorting power of something you want, even if it is not real? 你一定也多次经验过自己的知见如何受到想要之物的扭曲。 There are many instances of how what you want distorts perception. 没有人会怀疑小我作假诬告的本领。 No one can doubt the ego's skill in building up false cases. 也没有人会怀疑你对小我必然言听计从，直到你决心只接受真理的那一刻为止。Nor can anyone doubt your willingness to listen until you choose not to accept anything except truth. 唯有等到你决心放下小我，小我才会知难而退。When you lay the ego aside, it will be gone. 你愿聆听神灵多少，他的声音就会有多响亮。The Holy Spirit's voice is as loud as your willingness to listen. 他的声音如果过度响亮，就有侵犯你自由选择之嫌。神灵一心只愿帮你恢复自由，绝不会做出任何妨碍你自由的事。It cannot be louder without violating your freedom of choice, which the Holy Spirit seeks to restore, never to undermine. 圣灵会教你如何把身体纯粹用在你与兄弟的连接上，如此他才能透过你来传播他的信息。The Holy Spirit teaches you to use your body only to reach your brothers, so he can teach his message through you. 这不只会疗愈他们，同时也会疗愈你。This will heal them and therefore heal you. 任何一物只要按照圣灵心目中的任务而发挥其用，是不可能生病的。Everything used in accordance with its function as the Holy Spirit sees it cannot be sick. 违反这一原则才会引发疾病。Everything used otherwise is. 不要让身体成为反映心灵分裂的一面镜子。Do not allow the body to be mirror of a split mind. 也不要让它成为你卑微无能的标志。Do not let it be an image of your own perception of littleness. 更不要让它成为你攻击心态的倒影。Do not let it reflect your decision to attack. 只要你肯接受圣灵的诠释，不难看出健康其实是万物的自然状态，万物在圣灵眼中丝毫不具攻击性。Health is seen as the natural state of everything when interpretation is left to the Holy Spirit, who perceives no attack on anything. 只要你不再无情地利用身体，你不可能不健康的。Health is the result of relinquishing all attempts to use the body lovelessly. 只要你接受了那位深知生命真相且为生命发言的神师的指引，健康不过象征着正确的人生观依然在你心中生根发芽而已。 Health is the beginning of the proper perspective on life under the guidance of the one teacher who knows what life is, being the voice for life itself.
奇迹中文第八章回归之道 Chapter 8 The Journey Back
第八节身体是手段或目的 8 The body as means or end
愿大家有一个圣灵充满的一天阿们我爱你哟、哦